Not much. Mark wants to know Mark up for the call of death.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I was just going to play some Warframe for a bit.
Warframe!
Yeah, it's my new addiction.
I don't blame you.
Yeah.
Trust me. Cody's been on here and he's made several new friends.
Yeah. Hey.
Me and Mark.
I'm trying to level grind up to mastery rank 10 so I can make my warp.
Oh, wow.
And I'm almost there. That's a, holy crap, I'm like, I'm a notch off of the test rank 10. I might even get this game.
What game?
That Warframe, Mark. I'm trying to get the mastery rank 10. I'm a notch off doing the test.
Oh.
I'm just downloading off State Extra on my new PS Vita. I already explained it to Cody, but, well, it kind of cracked the screen on the old one. So I told my dad, don't worry, I'll think of something. When he came back from groceries, I saw the GameStop bag. I'm like, did he? And sure enough, it's a blue slim version.
Now you told me it's blue, I want to steal it from you.
If you do, I'm killing you.
If you try and kill me, I'll kill you back.
Bring it!
Oh, yes, it fits. It fits. Finally named my Kerbro. I thought of the perfect name. Terry Hint.
Kojiro?
No, Terry Hint. From Lisa.
Oh.
He has the same pattern as this tank top, too. It's like yellow with blue spots. It's awesome.
Oh, cool.
That's right. The Lord of Tutorials himself. He's here.
You know, I'm actually kind of glad my dad got the 2-year warranty on it. So in case if this thing gets broken or something, I can at least, it can be replaced for free.
Huh.
So it also comes with a free charger. Also came with a charger, too. Though it didn't come with a hard case to protect it from getting broken, so the guy's trying to look for it. Don't worry, I'm still going to get Dark Souls 3.
You better, you bitch.
Dude, I pre-ordered that thing, man.
You better, you bitch. So we got one Bolt Prime, two Nova Primes, and an Inaros.
Oh, wow. I can't wait to get a actual
I'm working
Prime.
On Chroma.
It's just like that one the host left. I don't know which we're down one.
Yeah, I gotta get some Neurotes to make some more Forma. So I can get up my Syndicate rank.
Yeah, Neurotes are difficult.
Not really.
I occasionally get some drops of Neurotes, but they're not as plentiful as Rubido.
Oh, yeah.
Of course they're not. They're a rare item.
Yeah.
Indiana Jones or what there?
Alright, I got about another 58 minutes until Fate Extra is done. Then I'm gonna go download the save files for it. Then I'm gonna maybe stream.
Okay.
And when I'm done this session, I hope you don't mind me reading some of my book. Because I was planning on doing that, and apparently you weren't in the call, and you made other plans. But yeah, I have a bunch of World of Warcraft books, so I was reading those to the guys every second day of the week.
Oh, cool.
I don't have all of them, but I'm going in order of what ones I have, which are, right now it's Arthas, and then it's going to be The Rise of the Horde. So I guess really Arthas kind of takes place through a lot of the books. But that's not the
point. Huh. So how do you feel about the movie?
I definitely want to see the movie.
It looks okay. I would have preferred it to be all in CG instead of having human actors or live action actors.
Yeah, really blame it there, but at least it looks authentic, right?
Yeah, it looks pretty good. Pretty authentic. Even though I'm not really that big a fan of Warcraft, but I like the orc designs.
Mm. Yeah, they're cool. Mm-hmm. I do like Total War's fantasy thing, though.
The chaos now, and you boot me out.
Yeah, I hate when people don't reply. You ask for an invite. They just blow you off.
No, not even that. Like, it's not that I didn't get invited. It's just I went 1 inch outside the map, and the game.
Okay.
And that is an insult to injury. One of the Grenier scorpions, is driving me off the map. And I got a flaming explosion. Nobody wants me at that spot. It's annoying. Revenge.
I hate those Grenier that teleport you. Are those the Grenier?
They're Grenier. Is that
like these four?
I don't know. There's some enemy that teleports you or something. Because when I was doing this defense mission, I kept like warping to different spots.
And it hurts the eye some bad.
What? Was this the stalker? Oh, jeez.
By the way, remember, Cody, when you mentioned about comparing some of the presidential candidates to characters from The Emperor's New Groove?
Yeah.
Who was Kronk again?
Kronk was Bernie.
Yeah, that fits him. He means well, but I don't think his plans will work in the long term.
Yeah.
I don't know, but...
Kayla Cusco was Trump, and I can't remember her name, but other lady was Yzma. Like, I know Yzma, I just don't know Hillary, or Miss Clinton, I don't know.
Yeah, Hillary
the lady
Clinton.
Who's the president, she's supposedly Yzma.
Yeah. Yeah, it's Hillary Clinton. Yeah. Really, at this point, it's the lesser of the two evils of who we had to vote for down here.
I kind of want to throw my hand with Sanders.
I think half the state wants to throw a good hand at Sanders. But then there's Trump and all those xenophobic racists littering the country. No offense.
Yeah, it's fine. We deal with it down here. Surprisingly, even though I'm from Texas...
Yeah, going on a massive pogrom.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I've been playing Witcher 3.
Oh, okay. Like I was saying...
Pogrom.
Even though I'm from Texas, you don't see a lot of Trump supporters down here. I guess in my city.
I guess even the Texas hate Trump.
Yep, it's that bad. Even the hardcore conservatives don't like him.
Mm-hmm. I'm assuming it's like one of those. You know, it's bad when.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's pretty bad.
If Trump wins, I hope Puerto Rico declares independence.
I wouldn't blame him.
Yeah, then I'll have a reason to go back to my homeland.
I wouldn't blame if actual states started declaring their independence like Texas did back in the day.
If that's the case, we're dead.
Uh-huh. No longer the United States anymore.
Nope.
More like the United Shitfest of America.
Yeah.
And then the Native Americans attempt to take back their land. It'd be like Shadowrun, but without the magic.
Yeah, unfortunately. The only magic is the magic of music.
Music can be inspirational, though.
That's right.
So Dan, if I had to recommend, I'm not sure if you're really that far to get it, but if I had to recommend you one weapon in Warframe, I think I've said this already, get a Tonk Core.
What's that again?
It's a grenade launcher.
Oh, okay. Hmm. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. I'll jot that down.
I would definitely advise a reload mod, though. It's really slow.
Uh-huh.
Split chamber's a good bonus.
Yeah, I've had some problems with a lot of the slower weapons. Hopefully I can get my hand on that mod, or hands on that mod. My hand, my singular hand. Don't know what I was saying.
It's hilarious.
Yeah, I'm still trying to get used to playing and talking.
No, no worries.
Yeah, but I always liked, just talking with people, even though I'm kind of an introvert.
I do not blame you.
Yeah.
I think we're all fairly withdrawn, but we like talking with people and that we can relate to.
Yeah, of course.
Of course, how do we talk with someone that doesn't have anything relating to us?
Yeah.
Welcome home!
Let's see. Speaking of which, I finally watched some episodes of Soul Eater Not. It's pretty good. I like,
I'm almost done with Log Horizon.
How's it so far?
Interrupting.
That's good. I was just wondering how was it so far? How was Log Horizon? Or how is Log Horizon?
It's good. I mean, compared to SAO, it's a bit better. Still a little outdated, but it's starting to get good. It's got humor.
What, is it like a lot of early 2000s, 90s kind
Hold
of
on.
Stuff? Yeah. They have those giant
yeah,
cell
I think
phones.
So. It's more like, I think it's got that charm that I think, well, I do like SAO, and while SAO mostly focuses on the typical showing kind of stuff, I think Log Horizon focuses more on the whole like aspects of like being in a world, like trying to change it. Although Grimgar of Fantasy and Ash is actually is really good. It's like a huge deconstruction.
A deconstruction of that kind of trope.
A fantasy world without memories thing.
Huh.
Yeah, and it's brutal.
I can imagine.
Like they don't even teach. It's more of a capitalist society. Like it costs money to actually join in a guild and. You have to, like, and, like, the guys have to scrape by just to survive.
Wow.
And death is permanent.
Oh, fun, permadeath.
Also, funerals are expensive. Permadeath.
So maybe I'll apply that reload mod. And next time around, I'll put on that speed trigger. And was Firestorm. No, I haven't. Wait, don't have Max Firestorm? No, Firestorm's already on there.
Alright, time to take Terry out for.
I'm really excited, though, for Dark Souls 3.
Yeah, it looks really good. I'm really hyped.
By the way, Dantic. Endless Legend expansion just dropped. The third one. And because of it, all of the DLCs and stuff are at a discount price.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Like, $3.39 for the Guardians expansion, $4.41 for the Shadows, and for Shifters, it's like $9-something. Total, it's $17.80, I think.
Huh.
I gotta redo the math.
Do you have the separate prices for the DLC? Do you have the separate prices out yet for the DLC? Or is it just a bundle? Alright, well, while he's looking that up, let's see what else. Oh, apparently on TBS they're gonna make this this MLG show. It's called Leagues or something. It's gonna be all, like, Major League Gaming.
Oh boy.
Yeah, I wonder how that's gonna turn out. No one takes that stuff seriously. The only time I actually enjoyed that kind of stuff was
Gaming version 2.
Yeah. The only time I enjoyed that stuff was the Nintendo Worlds Championship they did a couple of years back. That was actually really, really fun. Can't go wrong, Nintendo.
No, you really can't. If you have anything to say, you can meet my fist.
Yeah. Even though they do kind of make some really weird mistakes and weird choices. Like the whole Miitomo thing. I don't know, it just seems like an expansion for Tomodachi Life. That's pretty much all it is, in my opinion. Maybe they'll have it for other games, hopefully.
One can hope.
Apparently you can use profanity on Miitomo. So that's... Yeah, that's very un-Nintendo.
That's a thing.
Yeah. It's something Nintendo wouldn't really do, but I guess, you know, they want to change their image, maybe.
So they don't change it too much. They don't want to become Microsoft.
Yeah. Ooh. Is that a doggy? Doggy?
Yep. My folks are finally back. Now he can bug them.
Yeah. Actually, speaking of Texas, there's this really weird thing that happened on, April the 5th, with these, apparently this furry podcast...
Crop circle.
Huh?
Nothing.
Oh, okay, I was just gonna say this furry podcast was, like, broadcast on, like, Texas, like, public radio shows on their airwaves, like, really early in the morning, like, around 8 or 9. So, you know, parents would driving their kids to school listening to frickin'... I don't know, talking about hyper cowgirl tits or something. Just really awkward. Like, someone hacked into the, I don't know, they hacked into the radio show's systems or something. And just started broadcasting it. I think it was, like, a third party.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, Mark, the Codex is back.
Awesome!
I hate when I click out of the screen. The action gets too intense. Okay. I got this Prisma Tetra thing. Just because I had some ducats to spare. It's not too bad. It's not great, but, you know, puts in work, as they say. Though I can't wait to get my hands on an actual prime part.
The mission were you saying about the castle, is that Sunshine Tidings Corp?
Sunshine Tidings? No, you should get. You should be. I've gotten a mission from people.
Hey, they have to be a high level then. Be right back, guys.
You should have gotten a mission from Preston then. I think you need to help. I think you need to build up a few more settlements and then he'll give
it
to you.
A minute.
Be right back.
Okay, that's fine. I closed out the call accidentally. I was wondering why you guys weren't responding. I was like, oh, jeez. You guys ignoring me?
Really?
Yeah. It was getting so intense, the action. I was trying to freaking fight off all these corpus, and I think I clicked the red like phone sign icon thing accidentally.
Yeah, that happens from time to time.
I was like, guys, are you there? I'm not that annoying.
Hello? Anyone?
So anyways, I was saying, the Prismatetra's pretty good. You know, it's not great, but does a decent job. Though I did miss out on getting like 200 platinum for it. On the Warframe market. Oh well.
Oh yeah.
Hmm.
It happens.
Yeah. Yeah, but I enjoyed the market. It's pretty fun. It's like I'm in that one movie, Wall Street. Is it Charlie Sheen in that movie? I can't remember.
Starsky and Hutch.
Oh, I remember that. Owen Wilson. The movie or the actual original show?
Movie.
Uh-huh.
Bird, how did you get on the top of this house?
Oh, jeez. So many guys. Whistle a song. Hmm? Heard some whistling. I thought it was reverb or something.
Hacking, whacking, whacking. Seriously, how the hell did you get up there?
Anyway, I'll be right back, guys. Apparently, I have been voluntold to make breakfast for supper.
You can have brunch.
Very late brunch.
Okay. See you later.
Did Cody leave?
Yep. Yeah, he left.
Sorry if I'm not paying attention. I'm focusing on Vita and focusing on TV.
Uh-huh. So, new Fate Extra, is that it? Is it the little caster?
Yeah. Fate Extra, there's its then the sequel, Fate CCC, and then there's the recent one that I revealed, Fate Xtella. Which is, this is odd because
all right, there's I'll wait till you finish.
There's like two Sabers in that one because they intended for the new Saber, Attila, to be, well, the main character of it, but I think they just, I think they didn't even realize it when they added Nero, so I'm like, so there's two Sabers in this. It'd be awkward.
Yeah.
And the thing is, according to Grand Order, she's not actually from Earth. She's, I think, an alien. Like, her sword design looks completely different. She was found rather than born on Earth. She was, like, found somewhere.
It's going to be Xenu. It says it's going to be Scientology's Xenu. Just in a cute lolly form.
Yeah.
Scientology jokes. What is this? 2007.
I'm so excited for the Banner Saga 2. Might get that when it gets on the PS4. After they make the Banner Saga 1 free for the PlayStation Plus. Might stream that.
Yeah, I heard those were some good games.
Yeah.
A Rad Storm. Again.
Right now I'm just farming random items.
I swear you sound just like Pitching Ace 88 on YouTube.
Wait, who? Me?
Yeah. You remind me of him via the voice. You sound like him a bit.
Huh. Well, I'll take that as a compliment.
It is, actually. I mean, like, I actually watched Pitching Ace because he did, like, a Coder in Jade Empire. He was doing Sphinx, but apparently some of it got... I think the data got corrupted.
Oh, that sucks.
If anything, it really makes me wish they could have, like, I don't know, make a PC version.
Right. Or the port it to Steam or GOG or one of those sites.
Yeah.
That would be awesome. Mm. That and Jet Set Radio 2. Come on, Sega. Stop wasting your time with Sonic. There are other games out there.
Or Capcom, I mean, they're not taking Darkstalkers a bit seriously given the fact that they didn't sell to their expectations. I'm like, hey, it showed that there are so many people who love that game. You shouldn't just put it on the shelf because not that many people like your high expectations.
Yeah, well, apparently they're just going to be Street Fighter com, I guess, now. Even though 5 wasn't that good, from what I've heard.
I know. If anything, I wouldn't mind if, like, someone were to buy Darkstalkers.
Yeah. Become like an indie title.
Who could treat it right.
Oh, have you ever seen that one video that, it was like a 5-month-old or, like, a toddler or something? He was, like, playing Street Fighter V. And he was, like, just blazing through the story mode with, like, Birdie, I think.
Oh, yeah, it's not really much of a story mode if it's just a few minutes.
Yeah, I don't know if... Yeah, I think it was just a couple of minutes. But still, as a programmer, I don't know. I'd be a little embarrassed. Even if it was just a few minutes. Because with, like, the Miyazaki and the other guys who worked on Dark Souls, they, like, I don't know, they relish the fact that people have trouble with the game because it just shows how much work they put into it, but... I guess with Capcom, they don't really care as long as they make a quick buck.
Well, Capcom, I think, is kind of changing on that lately.
Huh.
They're doing a bit better now. I don't know, they're going to start playing more Assassin's Creed Chronicles. I need to complete India and Russia.
I haven't played that one yet. How is it?
It's good. It's actually good. The trilogy pack, it includes... I beat China, and I'm doing India right now. China at least explained a bit more about some about Xiao Jun. And well, India takes the you take on the you play
legendary.
The game as
coach.
Huh?
Oh. Ooh. You radiate the orbital shotgun. That's 50 points of additional radiation damage.
Ooh.
Give him the rads.
But yeah. But yeah,
legendary roach.
Huh. So what you're saying, Mark?
But
sorry.
Yeah, India, you play as the character in India called Arbas Mir. And as it turns out, he's actually the father of Henry Green in Assassin's Creed Syndicate. This is like before he eventually had him. And ironically enough, it's not really ironically, it's more like Henry Green's real name is actually Jayadeep Mir. He just chose the name Henry Green for
so he can keep his identity secret, I guess.
Disguise.
Yeah.
Well, as it turns out, it was Henry because there's a lot of people named Henry, and Green because it was the color of the hat he was wearing at the time.
Original, I guess.
And the last game, Russia, you play as the character Nikolai Orolev, who, if you read the comics and stuff for it, and according to Assassin's Creed 3, he is the ancestor to Daniel Cross. Basically, the assassin who switched the assassin sleeper agent for the Templars, who caused the Great Purge and the assassin situation to be what it is in the modern world.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cross
is dead. At least we explore a bit more of Nikolai's situation in Russia, because it's during the Red October Revolution, when the Tsarist government was overthrown. And for India, you're in the Sheikh Empire in Amritsar during the fall of the Sheikh Empire.
Oh, wow.
Well, yeah. Yeah, like, there's a lot of different reasons, but it also explains a bit more, and it puts a lot of things into perspective, really. I also love the environment. It looks beautiful. It really does.
Might have to check that out.
PS Vita.
It's only for the PS Vita?
Yeah. I got the trilogy. Huh? I have it on the PS4.
Cool.
Yeah. The trilogy pack. After I beat it, I don't know exactly what game I'll rent and get. But there's one thing I needed to mention is the fact that... Forgot. I know it was something important. Final Fantasy 14.
Oh yeah.
I'm gonna
trip
be
simulator.
Yeah. I was gonna basically mention, like, if anything, if that game were to go and do the Guild Wars 2 thing of buy it and that's it, you don't have to pay any subscription or anything.
Right.
Just buy to play. If it were to do that, I'm pretty sure they would get a shite ton of new subscribers.
Mm-hmm. Once again, all these game companies think in the short term. They just like to nickel and dime people. All the little extra stuff.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think it went free to play, did it? But
yeah, I guess so.
I hope it does one day, because I really want to try it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, someone in the recruiting text area section on Warframe, they're like requesting or looking for a female for sex slave or something. I was like, jeez, oh gosh, it's people.
Messed the fuck up.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I get it. I have a twisted sense of humor, but this guy. This freaking guy. Or a girl. Could be a girl. You know, want to be inclusive and all that.
It could be anyone.
Yeah. It's just like this guy on my squad right now, spank bitches. Freaking names. It's like this Kerbero from this one guy's squad who's called Raving Homosexual or something.
It's kind of a good thing that I don't really do the whole recruitment thing.
Yeah, it's a mixed bag.
I'm already in a clan, so I'm good.
Yeah, I'm in a clan too. They're called the Kauai Tactical Force or something. We have a freaking pony as our logo. It's I don't know. It was originally something else.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, but they changed it, I guess. I don't know. It'd be ironic. Alright, hopefully I can get my hands on an Orokin reactor blueprint. That'll be awesome. Use it on something else. Not sure what I'll use it on, though. I have a rhino, and I plan on getting...
Yeah, did you get that,
Huh?
Did you get those, year 3 weapon things for the 3 years of Warframe?
I don't think I did. I would probably saw, like, a message or something. Is that for, like...
Yeah, we kind of got PS4? Over here on the PS4.
Oh, okay. That's awesome. I guess that's one thing.
Yeah, dual sword, rifle, and dual pistols.
Oh, I think I got something similar to that. It was, like, the Dex something. Like, the Dex series of weapons.
Yeah, that's it. Dex set.
Yeah, I got those. Okay, so that's what it is. All right, yeah, I got those.
Yeah.
That it was something else. Hmm. Probably like a different name for it on the PC. Yeah, these weapons are good. The Dex weapons. Still using them.
Oh, yeah.
I hate when it lags too much. You know, it's like this delay when you're trying to pick something up. You guys know what toasting is? Nice, finally got that blueprint. Okay.
Okay, I got a bed sheet cover. Let me just put that in.
It's good to have your sheets. I need to change mine.
I have to change mine.
Oh. Yeah, it's usually good to change them, I guess. Once a week, I think? I'm not sure.
Oh, I mean, I have to change it because of Angel.
Oh, okay, right. Your dog. So how's Angel doing? Speaking of Angel, how's she doing?
Yeah, she's good. At least now with my folks here, she can finally annoy them and not me.
Mm-hmm. Aw, she just wants some love.
Yeah.
She's probably just doing it for attention.
Yeah. Around a bit.
So, any of you guys planning to see Hardcore Henry?
I heard that's a good one.
Yeah. Story wise, it's kind of but. I don't know, it's just all the action scenes are so well done, and there's a lot of practical effects.
And given the fact that it's in first person mode,
yeah, that too.
It.
It's kind of like that one part in Doom, the movie, that really bad movie with The Rock. It had the ending, it had like a first person section. I don't know, it works in Hardcore Henry, but for some reason doesn't work in that movie. I guess because at that point you might as well just be playing the game. That in the movie was awful.
Tricky. Alright. Okay.
Oh, sweet. I got a former blueprint. I'm doing a Tower 1 mission. I'm a lucky boy. Though I don't have any neurodes. So, yeah.
I need some help in the corner. Then I get the corner and I have to...
Hmm.
Be right back, guys.
Okay.
Need to get this corner. Wait. Wait, do I got it?
Which one?
That's what I was thinking about doing.
Pick it up, pick it up. Pick it up, 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 up. I want that to be our ringtone. Just pick it up. Ska music. Universal language of life.
Side. There's that. Okay, that'll work.
What is she? Being dry or is that dry?
It's using a new one.
Oh.
Alright. Okay, take care of that.
No problem.
Now for the sheet.
The dreaded sheet.
Wait.
Getting into it.
Sorry, you hear the clicking.
That's fine. Helps break up some of the silence. Oh, neurons. Yes, thank you. Only one, of course. Oh yeah, the Fooly Cooly's getting 12 or 13 new episodes. Yeah. Hear about that? Got it?
Yeah, you just gotta get the last part on the edge over here, and it's a bit difficult. Just gotta plug it in.
Go in the edge. The edge zone. The other guys went.
Yeah, it'll do. Not that be perfect, but it'll do.
Yeah.
As long as it doesn't keep breaking up for me. They got from the bed, I think. Yeah.
Daddy, we're gonna go for the nap. and then we take a bath later.
Why?
Center, please. No. Whoa. So did you get the sheet?
Blanket. All the pillowcases and the things are finished. And there. Okay, that's good. My friend David's been telling me to watch this show called Roswell Conspiracies.
Oh boy.
I actually seen a few episodes of it, and it's actually really good. It's like, huh?
I was just going to say, oh boy. Conspiracies.
Yeah, it's like where the whole myth of, you know, vampires, werewolves, and all that stuff, it's they're actually aliens.
Huh.
Yeah. It's actually really good. It's like from the early 90s, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's like I really like it. I mean, characters are pretty fun.
Yeah.
The designs for all the creatures like Yeti, Banshee, Lycanthropes, vampires, all that interesting.
Yeah, I've been watching a little bit of X-Files, the new series. It's pretty good. It's getting into the old Illuminati kind of crazy stuff.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
I really can't wait for Deus Ex Mankind Divided.
Oh yeah, that's going to be really good.
I actually tried to go pacifist, but I kind of goofed.
Oh yeah, it's hard in the very ending of Human Revolution because all those people are like swarming you. And you like run out of like means to pacify them without killing them.
Yeah, but it was more like the fact I goofed into on China before I did the Missing Link DLC. I played on the Wii U, so.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I heard that port was interesting.
That port is awesome.
I'll take your word for it. I actually haven't played it. I've only played the 360 version.
Just gonna say it right now, the port, it not only shows you a map of the place, but it also shows you like all the messages on the computer. You don't have to squint to read it. It just pops up on the gamepad.
Oh yeah, that would be very useful in the gamepad.
Oh yeah. Imagine the Metroid Prime trilogy being able to do that.
Oh yeah, that would be awesome. You don't have to read through all those codexes.
Codex entries on that thing? Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Actually, my name on Warframe was DeeZee Dog, but it's spelled with A-U-G. It's actually a reference. It's like this in-joke I made when playing Human Revolution. There's this one conversation with this one guy who's like talking about making augmentations for dogs or something. I said, you can open up a store, call it Dogs. D-A-U-G-S. It's a really bad joke. Yeah. That's pretty cool, though. Though kind of a waste of money, I guess, because when the dog dies.
Yeah.
So how's the story going so far?
My novel or the fanfic?
Fanfic. Either one, though.
Well, fanfic's still going a little good, introducing the last two members of the Guardians, and, well, Solaris is one of them, introducing the other four. Mm-hmm. And as for the novel, I'm slowly making my way into it. Added a little scene with the added like a chapter with the Kaiser, and now it's more of Rin, the newswoman for the ANN.
Yeah,
she's on Earth doing a bit of an expose with what's going on.
Hmm.
So she's currently in a city somewhere in the Middle East. I didn't really specify it. I'd say maybe I don't know Iran, Iraq.
Oh,
I didn't really specify which province in the Middle East. But she's mostly just bored out of her mind right now because she has literally nothing to do with an expose on. And her cameraman's just eating some food right there. And she's like, he's like, okay, I know for a fact you're anxious to get some news, but why are you here again? But you really shouldn't, like, complain because you could be a whole lot worse. And then she just asks him, I know, but wait, what the heck are you doing in here? What the heck are you doing on Earth anyway? To be honest, I'm still an intern. I needed to find some. I thought going into games journalism would let me explore. Like, the universe and stuff. I didn't expect to be watched on this world, though.
Huh. Oh, yeah. Cool.
I had the idea of introducing the Crown Prince of Jacobia, and the Prince of Maser. Oh. Yeah, I'm throwing Maser in here, man.
Oh wow!
Because they have a reason to being in the Middle East as well.
Huh.
They want to save their people, or rather, they're going to want to offer them a chance to leave this place, but never to return, but a chance to live. Problem is, it will probably mean that they won't be able to go on Earth anymore. But as they said, it's a small sacrifice to pay for the chance for peace.
Oh, I see.
And in hindsight, when you later on in the novel, that little thing actually makes sense.
Alright, well, can't wait to actually read it. It'll be good.
I showed it to my cousin. He got to the part when Darius is first introduced, and he said he likes it.
So, like you said, did you plan on publishing it or something?
I do plan on publishing. I just don't know where.
Yeah, it's kind of rough trying to figure out.
Yeah, not really publishing firms in Pennsylvania.
Oh, Yeah, and if you do find one, they're usually like not local. Kind of like in the more urbanized areas.
I do plan on one day hoping it becomes a manga and then an anime series, but first I gotta get this published.
Yeah.
I remember reading on Elsa's review on FA that there was indeed a that there was an anime that was actually adapted from a novel.
Yeah, a lot of those animes get adapted from like light novels. Can't remember it was like this. This one about like priests and vampires. I can't remember the actual name, but it was on Adult Swim like a long, long time ago. That was apparently a light novel originally. Let's see, maybe I can find it. Kind of in the middle of something, but you know, whatever. I'll look into it. Okay. Let's wait for my freaking iPod to load. This thing's so old.
Okay, I took care of that. Fate Extra is officially on my Vita.
Cool.
Yes. Now I must get them to YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah, so apparently Trigger, the people who made Kill la Kill, are making this new anime. It's like this it's about this like can't remember, it's something to do with like this outer space kind of police officer kind of thing.
Fully Cooley?
Oh no, it's not Fully Cooley. It's something else.
Because I heard finally making a second, third season for it.
Yeah, I mentioned that earlier. I wonder what they're gonna take the story. Or, you know, because it kind of ended in not necessarily open and shut, but I'm not sure where they can really go from all the craziness that happened in the first season. She'll be good, though. I guess Naoto will be, like, in his teens, maybe. Or a little bit older. The premise of the first one was about growing up and all that.
I think they might go with something with a manga? I don't know. We gotta see.
I actually haven't read the manga. Heard it was good, though.
this weird idea late. I had this weird idea once when I woke up.
What?
It was still buzzing around in my head, and it was this kind of idea for this sort of mech show.
Mm-hmm.
But they have to face off against these like other creatures from another dimension.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is, like, as they get more and more, like, as like, well, like at first it thinks it's like the monster of the week thing, but it turns out they're searching for something.
Hmm.
And long story short, the first time those guys invaded was shortly after the discovery of the dimension.
Mm-hmm.
And those things invaded and they tried to kill, and they basically almost wiped out all of mankind.
Hmm.
I don't know if they were dragons or something. I can't remember. But anyway, they eventually, the survivors built mechs to try to counter them, and it was supposed to be going on this, and it was still this sort of stalemate, really.
Oh.
Well, mechs combined with the whole military thing. They kind of had to unite.
That'd be awesome.
Anyway, main protagonist is the son of the director, blah, blah, blah. They start fighting it off, but then it soon gets to the point where the leader just comes in to personally lead an assault.
Mm-hmm.
Almost manhandles the crew, then reveals when he goes into his mind, and it sort of causes some kind of disruption where it actually... the video screens like see what's going on in his mind, and they find out he's communicating with them. And he reveals to the MC that he's actually after his son.
Oh.
Because it turns out crazy. What?
Huh?
Crazy.
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good to finally hear you guys. Like, you bailed on us.
Yeah, but anyway, they find out that when the dimensions were first revealed to one another, the guys on the other side of the dimension that were invading, they were a bit curious about it, and when they first made contact, it was sort of like peaceful and stuff, but when the humans saw how advanced they were, like, oh shit, we gotta find out how we were gonna do this, how are they this powerful? So they ultimately decided, maybe we can at least try to ask. Except for the director, who turns out to have been one of them, one of the guys in the first expedition, he basically decided to instead of waiting, he decided to take action, because he was afraid of their power.
Hmm.
So he ended up taking the leader's kid, and had him housed in there in a secret facility. That triggered the whole war.
Hmm.
When the remaining humans learn about that the director of humanity was the one who... Oh, boy.
Hmm.
The whole unity just defrays, and people are blaming not only the director, but his son, because... Well... The father was about to kill him, but the director basically was like, I have your son. I know where he is. Leave my son be, and I'll give him back.
Hmm.
The invading father agrees, but he says if he backstabs it, he will destroy everything. When the director's forced his hand and he has to reveal everything, let's just say shit's officially going down.
Right.
Because pretty soon the humans start... Huh?
I was just saying, wow, the way you were able to just come up with all these ideas, I'm still kind of struggling with some of my storylines.
Yeah, Marcus seems like a runaway avalanche.
I know.
More like a rock slide, when I think about it.
Rock slide!
Super not effective.
Sorry.
Is that a Pokemon move? I don't
know.
I haven't played in a while.
I need to get back to playing. What's that? I need to get back to playing Pokemon. Just need to get to playing it more often.
Yeah, I just Wonder Trade for the most part.
Who's the legendary giveaway this time?
Oh, Jirachi! What? Oh, dang! I almost forgot about that. I need to get that. Let's see if we can do it now.
Yes, I'm here.
You got all pumped, don't worry about it.
You go what?
Horse, grab!
Cody, how many Kimpos knew you? Celebi, then who?
After
Celebi is Jirachi, and Jirachi is Darkrai.
Okay, For some reason, I was thinking Darkrai.
Now, it's going in order of generation, so I said, this month is Jirachi, next one is Darkrai.
Hmm. Huh? That makes sense.
You suck. Thing is, Mew was the easiest one. Go to the store and ask for code.
Yeah, you got this little card.
Oh, yeah, this is for you. Remember, GameStop here is like an hour and a half away.
Uh-huh. GameStop. More like LameStop.
I was stuck and unable to get there.
I think it's actually EB Games. Is this called GameStop everywhere else? So
wait,
why
you guys
not?
Still have EB Games? Oh, those are awesome.
And you guys are breaking up on my end.
Mm-hmm.
We're fawning at the fact that we still have an EB Games.
Oh,
Don't say nothing.
Do you guys still have EB Games in the UK, Dave?
No, we just have a shop called Game over here.
Oh, how's that?
Dude, right? Game. HMV does games, but... Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know HMV does. We've got HMV here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we just... Well, are just all our local game shop or video games, accessories and stuff is just called Game.
Just called Game. Oh, I like it.
Game. G-A-M.
G-A-M.
Yeah. Mm. And then what's funny, just further up the, what would you call that in the center, that little bit that's further up?
A hill?
No, it's a flat place, but it's just like further up a few, it's like a little alleyway bit in the center. Like, you know, you got like the big wide that you go through, and you can turn left and just like cut through most of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Game was in there, but just further up past it was another shop called Game Station.
Game Station.
And I think at first they weren't though, and then they both became the same. Random.
Game Station.
Yeah. Oh, I thought they were two separate companies. Then merged.
Yeah, they've always happened.
Oh, I never knew that. Okay. What I was about to say is completely wrong, but Jordan's just corrected that. Not bad. Like, I didn't know.
I'm sure they're twice as better as GameStop.
So I didn't sound like an idiot. So you kind of saved me. I just made you sound cool. Don't crawl. Yell at him. Tell him he smells.
You smell.
Thank you, Cody.
Cheers, Cody.
He says cheers.
No, yeah, right. After I finish this game, maybe I'll see about reading another chapter. You don't mind if I do a bit of reading, do you, Danzig?
Sure. Go ahead. It'll be interesting.
You mind?
Yeah, I don't mind.
Cody's going to be doing reading from a walk. Okay, Jordan doesn't mind either.
Actually, before you do that, I have one quick thing to show you guys. Hold on, let me see if I can find it. It's about the Star Wars Rogue One trailer. And just at the end, just Mark Hamill's face. Oh my gosh, he looks like he just doesn't want to be there. It's just the worst. I don't know. It's just something about it that just touches me at a bit.
Why did I just think of like his head's pulled back, eyes wide, just like looking. He's like, why am I here?
Yeah, let me see if I can. How do you send like messages or not messages like?
Hey,
hold on.
I have to get the computer. I think Andor or Lido or something more. Plus a month. I still want to do that idea, like I sort of like down on the back of that side. Using the Palatine Emperor's children's swords and just in make command swords with them.
You have it.
Normal Mark 4 command sword?
Yeah, this one has studs.
Yeah, one has studs, the other one doesn't.
Maybe at least some light bulbs.
Actually, I think this one has.
Alright, sending it to you guys now.
Yeah, it's a little bit raised up. Well, back in the Heresy, it kind of makes sense, but in 40k, if you can't even see it, it only looks better on like veterans or commanders of some sort, you know, captains, that kind of stuff. Doesn't look good, it doesn't work on the squad, does it?
Wait,
no.
The...
I mean, back in the Heresy. You have enough, probably. Because, I don't know, have you ultimately decided on what to do with your second box of Cal? Because one
of the thoughts was you were just going to put both together, so you outnumbered me. But I have more firepower.
Okay.
Open, Captain.
Yeah, you guys can continue what you were doing. I was just messing around.
Alright. I'll take that look in a moment. Things are a little hectic over here.
It's actually just tempted to, I don't know. I had multiple cards. One of them was buy another cat box and combine them to my existing and for children's box. So I turned my 10 man to 20 men. Maybe make a special squad with 5 moves or make it. Fine. Because we just run away crying. Is that Jimi Hendrix? Okay.
Jimi Hendrix?
Yeah, John just stopped on the song for that.
Huh.
Oh, right. I'll pop that. Okay.
Yeah, he was pretty cool, dude.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of other music do you like?
Alright, I'm done. Let me get the book.
Oh, by the way, Danzig.
Hmm?
I have actually been watching a new anime series lately. It's called Boku no, no Hero Academia.
Oh, okay. I was thinking, oh gosh, Boku no Pico. No.
Force for Change.
Huh. How's that so far?
Huh?
I was wondering, how was that new anime you're watching so far? How was it?
Well, it's only got the first episode, but it's good.
Ah, cool.
It better be good, or else I'll thank you.
Very wasting my time.
I'll be honest, I watched I read the manga of it before, and I liked it. Now,
what's it about?
Chapter 8.
Cool.
It's basically a spin on life. Like everything's the same to modern life, except superpowers are a common thing. Like everybody's born with some sort of particular superpower, except this one kid. This one kid has some sort of defect in his genetic, or he does not have any powers. Granted, he gets some later, but that's not the point.
Huh.
But essentially, that's what the whole world is just common life with superpowers.
That's cool.
I just want to give some example. Like, there's one of the characters that are there. There's one whose sweat is pretty much combustible.
Oh.
Another whoever she touches makes it float. Another guy who can run really fast. Another who can make shadow. Would be fair to say a shadow copy of himself? I don't know.
Another who is made out of wood.
Oh.
And one that can turn herself into a giant. And nowhere in between. Just either a normal person, or a 30-story building, 30-foot tall, no, more like 50-foot tall building.
Wow.
There's no medium.
It's Go big or go home.
Yep. Now, Dulk. Chapter 8. The palace had never been so cheerfully decorated for the Feast of Winter Vale as it was this year. Muradin, ever a good ambassador of his people, had brought the dwarven tradition to Lordran upon his arrival. Over the years, it had been increased in popularity, and this year, the people seemed to truly take it to heart. The festive tone had been... Hold on, I need to take the retainers out. As the co-worker said at work, braces are just like glasses for your teeth. And they're a pain in the butt. I should not probably put them on my feet. The festive tone had been established a few weeks earlier, when Jenny had delighted them so with the theatrical display of igniting the Wicker Man. She had been granted permission to stay through the winter if she so chose, although Dalaran was not far to one who could teleport herself. Something had changed. It was both subtle and profound. Jaina Proudmoore was starting to be treated more than the daughter of the ruler of Kol Tiras, more than a friend. She was starting to be treated like a member of the royal family. Arthas first realized it when his mother took both Jaina and Kalia to be fitted for the formal dresses fashion required for the Winter Vale to eat ball. Other guests had spent Winter Vale here. Leanne had never before wanted to coordinate their outfits with her own and that of her daughter. Sorry if I start fumbling over words. I'm bad for that.
It's okay.
Two, Terranos now often requested that Jaina join him and Arthas when they sat to listen to the people's petitions. She sat on the king's left, Arthas on his right, in a position nearly equal to the king's own son. Well, Arthas thought, he supposed it was the logical conclusion, wasn't it? He recalled his words to Kalia years ago. We each have our duties, I guess. You to marry whoever father wants, and me to marry well for the kingdom. Jaina would be good for the kingdom. Jaina, he thought, would be good for him too. So why did the thought make him feel so uneasy? They had brushed snow the night before Winter Vale. Arthas stood looking out a large window at Lordamir Lake, frozen over now. The snow had begun falling at dawn and had stopped about an hour ago. The sky was black velvet, the stars small icy diamonds against the soft darkness, and moonlight made everything look still, hushed and magical. A soft hand slipped into his. Beautiful, isn't it? Jaina said quietly. Arthas nodded, not looking at her. Plenty of ammunition. What? Ammunition, Jaina repeated. For snowball fights.
Oh no.
He finally turned to her as his breath caught. He had not been permitted to see the gown she, Kalia, and his mother would be wearing to banquet and ball this evening. And he was stunned by her beauty. Jaina Proudmoore looked like a snow maiden. From shoes looked to be made of ice, to a white gown tinged with the palest blue, to a circuit of silver that caught the warm glow of the torchlight. She was heartbreakingly lovely. But she was no ice queen, no statue. She was warm and soft and alive, her golden hair flowing about her shoulders, her cheeks pink beneath the admiring gaze, her blue eyes bright with happiness. You're like a white candle, he said, all white and gold. He reached for a lock of her hair, twirling it about his fingers. He grinned. Yes, she laughed, reaching to touch his own bright locks. The children will almost certainly be blonde. He froze. Oh, no. Jaina, are you? She chuckled. No, not yet. But there's no reason to think we wouldn't be able to have children. Children, again. The word that galvanized him in shock and peculiar distress. She was talking about children they would have. His mind galloped into the future. A future with Janya's wife, their children, and his parents.
You did the veterans list?
No, not the veterans. Ah, oh. You can take from my not full form of the person. No, not very much. But then, not full form of the person. Yeah. I think about it.
I'm gonna start streaming Transistor, okay?
Okay, I hope you don't mind me continuing the read.
I don't mind.
His parents gone, himself on the throne, and the weight of the crown on his head. Part of him desperately wanted that. He loved having Janya by his side. Loved holding her in his arms at night. Loved the taste and smell of her.
Welcome to part 5 of Transistor. On Twitch this time. Last time we left off, we managed to get all the way to the top of the tower where Asher Kendril the Camerata is. And apparently he's deciding to take all the blame for it.
Sean Company.
Well, him and Camerata.
I just say that.
Seems like the process of working with him anymore. Sorry about that pausing. Talking with some friends on Skype.
Pure as a bow and sweet as the scent of roses. He loved...
Anyway.
Suddenly, he knew that until this moment,
he had an open childhood. The fact he's got a code, sick suspicion, and what happened to him. Keep going.
He thought of Janya as a companion, just as he had been since his boyhood, except their games were now of a more adult nature. But suddenly shifted inside him. What if this was real? What if he really was in love with her, and she with him? What if he was a bad husband, a bad king? What if I'm not ready? He blurted. Her brow furrowed. Well, we do not have little ones right away. She squeezed his hand, in what was clearly intended to be a gesture of reassurance. Artha suddenly dropped her hands and took a step back. Her frown deepened in confusion. Arthas, what's wrong? Janya, we're too young, he said, speaking rapidly, his voice rising slightly. I'm too young. You're still... I can't. I'm not ready. She paled. You aren't... I thought... Gildrakt him. She'd asked him this, the night they became lovers. Are you ready for this? She had whispered. I am if you are, he had replied. He really had thought he meant it.
The transistor to control the city.
Arthur reached out and grabbed her hand, trying desperately to articulate the emotion that raced through him. I will have so much to learn, so much training to complete, and Father needs me. Uther's got so much he needs to teach, and Janya, we've always been friends. You've always understood me so well. Can't you understand me now? Can't we still be friends?
That's not the person you tell. That's not a thing you say to the love of your life.
Her bloodless lips opened, but no words came out at first. Her hands were limp in his. Almost frantically, he squeezed them.
Janya, please. Please understand. Even if I don't.
Of course, Arthas. Her voice is monotone. We'll always be friends. You and I. Everything from her posture to her face to her voice bespoke her pain and her shock. But Arthas clung instead to her words with a wave of relief. So profound it made his knees weak, swept over him. It was all going to be just fine. It might upset her now, a little, but surely she'd understand soon. They knew each other. She figured out that he was right and that it was too soon. I mean, this isn't forever, he said, feeling the need to explain. Just for now. You've got studying to do. I'm sure I've been a distraction. And Tinnitus probably resents me. She said nothing. This is for the best. Maybe one day it will be different and we can try again. It's not that I don't... He pulled her into his arms and hugged her. She was stiff as stone for a moment. Then he felt the tension leave her and her arms around him. They stood alone in the hall for a long time, Arthas resting his cheeks against her bright golden hair. The hair that, no doubt, their children would indeed have been born with. Might still be born with. I don't want to close this door, he said quietly. It's all right, Arthas. I understand. He stepped back, his hands on her shoulders, peering into her eyes. Do you? She laughed slightly. Honestly, no, but it's all right. It will be eventually, anyway. I know that. Genya, just I want to make sure this is right. For both of us. I don't want to mess this up. I can't mess this up. She nodded. She took a deep breath and steadied herself, giving him a smile. A real, if hurting, smile. Come, Arthas. You need to escort your friend to the ball. Arthas somehow made it through the evening, and so did Janya, although Tyrios kept giving him strange glances. He didn't want to tell his father, not yet. It was a strained and unhappy night, and at one point during a pause in the dance, Arthas looked out at the blanket of white snow and the moon's silver sleep, and wondered why everything bad seemed to happen in winter. Well, he's not wrong! Lieutenant General Thaddeus Proudmoore didn't look particularly happy to have this exclusive audience with King Tyrios and Prince Arthas. In fact, it looked like he desperately would like to slink away unnoticed. The years had not been kind to him, neither physically nor in the hand fate had dealt him. Arthas recalled a handsome, rather dashing military commander who, while doubtless overpound of his strength, at least seemed able to keep the ravages at bay. No longer. Blackmore's hair was streaked with gray, he had put on weight and his eyes were bloodshot. He was, fortunately, stone cold sober. Had he shown up this meeting intoxicated, Tyrios, a firm believer in the needs for moderation of all things, would have refused to see him. Blackmore was here today because he had messed up badly. Somehow, the man's prized gladiator orc, Thrall, had escaped Durnhold in a fire. Blackmore had tried to keep it quiet and to conduct his search for the orc personally on a small scale. But a secret as large as a massive green orc could not be contained forever. Once word had gotten out, rumors flew wildly, of course. It was a rival lord who had freed the orc, anxious to ensure winning in the rings. Jealous mistress, hoping to embrace him. It was a clever band of orcs, unaffected by the strange lethargy. No, it was Orgrim Doomhammer himself. It was dragons. Infuriating disguised as humans, who lit the place afire with only their breath. Arthas had thought Thrall exciting to watch in combat, but he recalled that even when the thought had crossed his mind, whether it was wise to train an educated orc, when information had come that Thrall was on the loose, Tyrios had summoned Blackmore immediately. Or unaccounted. It was bad enough you thought it was a good idea to train an orc to fight in gladiatorial combat, Tyrios began. But to train him in military strategy, to teach him to read, to write? I must ask, Lieutenant General, what in the light are you thinking? Arthas smothered a grin as Aladeus Blackmore seemed to physically diminish right in front of his eyes. I would be smiling too, to be fair.
It is the last.
You assured me that the funds and materials were directly into stepping up security, and your pet orc was securely guarded, Tyrios continued. And yet somehow he was out there instead of safely inside Dirthold. How was that possible? Blackmore frowned and rallied somewhat. It was clearly unfortunate through all his escapes. I'm sure you understand how it must feel. It was a hit on Blackmore's part. Tyrannos is still smart from the fact that Doomhammer had escaped from under his very nose. But it wasn't a particularly wise hit. Tyrannos frowned and continued. I hope this isn't part of some disturbing trend. The money is earned from the labor of the people, Lieutenant General. It goes towards keeping them safe. Do I need to send along a representative to ensure that the funds are properly distributed? No, that won't be necessary. I will account for every penny. Yes, Tyria, said Tyrios with a decisive mildness. You will. When Blackmore finally left, bowing obscurely the whole way out, Tyrios turned to his son. What are your thoughts on the situation? You saw Thrall in action. Arthas nodded. He wasn't all like I had imagined him to be. I mean, he was huge and fought fiercely, but it was obvious that he was so intelligent and trained. Tyrios stroked his beard, thinking. There are pockets of renegade orcs out there, some who might not have this lassitude that the orcs we've imprisoned have demonstrated. If Thrall were to find them and teach them what he knows, it could be a very bad thing for us. Arthas sat up straighter. This could be what he'd been looking for. I've been training with Uther, and he had been. Unable to properly explain to others and to himself why they had ended the relationship with Janya, he'd thrown himself into his training. He thought for hours a day until his body ached. Attempting to sufficiently exhaust himself so he can get her face out of his mind. It had been what he wanted, hadn't it? She'd taken it well, so why is it why was it he who lay awake at night, missing her warmth and presence, with a pain that bordered on agony? He had even embraced Hithero, despite hours spent in still, silent meditation in an effort to distract himself. Maybe if he focused on fighting, on learning how to accept and channel and direct the light, he'll get the hell over her, over the girl that he himself had broken up with. We could go looking for such orcs, find them before Thrall does. Tyrannos nodded. Uther has informed me of your dedication and is very impressed with your progress. He reached a decision. Very well then. Go tell Uther and start preparing. It's time for your first taste of a real battle. Arthas was hard put not to let a loop of excitement. He refrained, even in his delight picking up on pain, looked to his father's face. Maybe, just maybe, killing a rebellious greenskin would erase memory of Janya's stricken expression when he'd ended their relationship. Thank you, sir. I'll do you proud. Despite the regret in the father's blue-green eyes, so like Arthur's own, Tyria smiled. That, my son, is the least of your worries.
And that was chapter 8.
Cool.
Oh.
Yeah, it was.
That was pretty good. It just said my mic turned off for a bit.
Eh, no worries.
Well, I'm currently in a now processed cloud bank. Apparently the two Camerata members I was sent to kill killed themselves.
And I'm playing not Stardew Valley. Playing Harvest Moon.
Not Stardew Valley?
Yeah. I wish I had it. Uh, Yeah, I had this really interesting thing happen to me when I went into Barnes & Nobles. I was looking for this book called Silverwing by Kenneth Appel. I think that's his name. Because I really like the cartoon adaptation of it. And I wanted to actually read the book. But when I asked the clerk, he was like, because they didn't have it there, they were like looking for it. And apparently they didn't have that, but they had this book called Silver Wings. And it's about like sexuality or homosexuality. And he just looked at me for a few minutes like, are you sure this is what you're looking for? He wasn't like being judgmental or anything, but he was like looking at me. I was like, oh, jeez. It's not what you think, man. I don't know. Maybe it's my eyelashes. They kind of look very soft, I guess. People kind of think those thoughts. I don't know.
Come on, gang, don't crap out on me now. Not that this test is hard, but I'd like to not do it again. Mastery rank 10!
Cool.
And now all I need is the ferrite and I can make the war.
War?
Make love, not war.
There's no Ford work on it.
It's like camera action, professional sparks, hysteria, initiated Kendrell release from service, OBC service center contaminated, local secretary offers services. As I stand here on the eastern perimeter, awaiting the inevitable, I'm surrounded by my community, and I'm at peace. It has been my honor and my privilege helping spread the news of the day among the people of this city. And my only regret is having no more time to share with you all. To the west, I see nothing. To the east, there is nothing.